I've got something amazing for you today, and you don't have to be on Office 365. You can be on the world's oldest version of Excel, and you can use this right now. It's something you desperately need. It's a date picker. Why does Excel not have a date picker? Well, someone on the Excel team, Sam Rad, said, yeah, it should have a date picker, and he's given us one for free. This is episode 2340. Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. All right, check this out. Our buddy Sam Rad, that's on the Excel team. He is one cool dude. SamRadApps.com/datepicker. Download it. And an awesome tip from Sam. Have you ever had an add-in that stops loading? And so Sam says, the more reliable way to do this is File Options Advanced. Scroll down here to At Startup, Open All Files In. Create a folder there, C:XL Start. You can call it whatever you want, of course. And then take Sam's add-in and put it in that folder. Then every time you open Excel, this will automatically start. So much more reliable than tools, add-ins, or file options, add-ins, manage, blah, 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 blah. All right, so this is awesome. First off, you get a date picker icon right here with options for today's date or the date and time. Now, hey, look, I know you're going to say, well, wait a second. Current date, we can do that easily with Ctrl+Semicolon. Yes, you can. But current date and time, that is a super pain because you have to do Ctrl+Shift+Colon and then Ctrl+Semicolon all together. I actually have a macro that I use for that all the time. And nice job, Sam. You can right click and say, add that to the quick access toolbar. It's already up there for me. So now I have just a single click to get the current date and time. I'm using current date and time all the time. But the thing that appears to be really cool is if the current cell you're in has a date or the cell above you has a date, then we get an on-grid UI there. And you can just go choose a date. Want to choose a date from next month? No problem. If you want to choose a date from many years from now, click on 2020. You can go down to 2025, but you can also go bam, 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 all the way out to however far you want to go. And then choose a date. If you want to choose a different month, let's go to December. Choose 29th, December 29th, 2043. If you choose a date that is in the future and open the date picker, it will already start out in 2043. So if it wasn't the 29th, it's the 24th. It's very easy to change. This is awesome and free and works in every version of Excel, going back to Excel 2007. Oh, here's another cool tip. So here we'll go to this cell, click the icon. If I click down here, I get the current date. If I right click down there, I get the current date and time. What a great, great tool. If you're in a cell that doesn't have a date, just right click and date picker is right at the top of the list. Free from Sam Rad. Just go out to samradapps.com/datepicker. I'm going to install this on every single PC. Thanks to Sam for this awesome, awesome tool. Hey, if you like these tips, please subscribe and ring that bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the YouTube comments below. My new book, Mr. Excel 2020, click that I in the top right-hand corner. Well, I want to thank Sam Rad for that awesome tool. I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.